Abu Dhabi and enjoyed a desert safari. I have even walked to the seashore of Goa and admired the beauty of the seashells. But there is one field I walked through for the first time in my life, and that path is still going on. That's the verdict. Are we going into an apocalypse or a huge industrial transformation? Well, I would like to take you to the journey of robotics in my life. When I was 10 years old, I used to be very mischievous and I did not decide my age yet. Whenever my parents used to ask me, I used to say different answers. But once seriously they asked me that what do I want to do in life, I said that I will become an engineer. But I wasn't sure which field shall I go in, electric, mechanic or software. At the same time, there was a robotics summer camp in my apartment and I had joined it. I found it very Then I thought that I will become a robotic engineer. The next year, I joined another summer camp which was called the PewDiePie Robotics. Over there, I started building on robots. I would like to show them to you. The first one is the plant watering robot. My father had given me a responsibility to water the plants, but often I used to forget. He used to scold me that why didn't I water the plants. I did not used to understand, and I used to say, why are you scolding me for not watering a plant? But when that plant had died because of no water, I felt very bad. Then I thought that if I am interested in robotics, why can't I make a robot that can water the plants for me? With the help of my sir, I made a robot that can water the plants according to their moisture. I would like to show it to you. That is the plant watering robot. As you can see, that its sensors are going into the soil to measure the water moisture. It has water to water if the moisture is less. It had read the moisture and watered the plant. That is how it works. Let me tell you another interesting story. I had another robot, but there's a whole new story. That was the circle drawing robot. I always used to have a limitation. I won't be able to draw proper and cube circles with the help of compass. And even when I drawed it with my hand, it used to become the map of some other country. Then I thought, why not? Can I build a robot for this? But I didn't have any idea how to make that. My sir explained me which kind of angle is necessary for what radius. And thus, me and my sir made a robot that can go around the circle. This is me while building the robot. Then sir explained me which angle shall I give the robot to go around the given circle. Now, the final time is for testing. The robot had been given the angle and let's see, can it make a circle? And there you see, it had made a perfect circle. But last and not the least, one of my favorite robots, the chatbot. Wouldn't you like to have a friend who can talk to you or who can help you in your homework by solving your math problems? It's possible. There is a robot which can do all those things for you. I would like to show you how it works.
This is a chatbot. Now it's going to interact with me. I'm going to ask it a few questions and it's going to answer me according to my questions. Take a selfie.
It's selfie time.
What is 6 plus 4?
The answer is 10. I am Agent Cutie Pie.
Take a picture.
Say cheese.
This chatbot, now took a selfie of me, answered the mathematical question, said its name, and took a picture. This means it's a very interactive bot.
Artificial eye. Right now, there is even an artificial limb or the artificial hand. That is the artificial hand. You can control it by your brain. It takes the advantage of regenerated nerves in your cut hand and attaches them to sensors to make it work like a natural hand. But there is one limitation. You cannot feel or sense with such a hand. In the future, we might be able to create such a hand that might be able to work just like a natural hand, which would be able to touch, sense and feel. And like I showed you the two robots and the AI robot, I would like to conclude that in the future, we all would have our own customized robots. Robotics will be used to solve our day-to-day problems and for solving complex maths and science problems. The future generation will be like custom robots will be a common solution to all our problems. Thank you.